In this video, I'll show you how to add a section view onto a drawing in Solidworks. So we've got this wheel, it's got a lot of features. This view here is fine. If we project over a standard right side view, end up with all these hidden lines. And part of the challenge is we're going to have to dimension this. So remember, you don't dimension the hidden lines. So that becomes an issue. Plus, just a matter of that this doesn't really add a lot of clarity to the drawing. So instead of doing a view like that, what we can do is replace it. So sometimes you add section views in addition to your standard views, and other times you replace your standard views with sections. So just go to View Layout, Section View. Now you have to decide about the direction of your cutting plane line. Do you want a vertical cutting plane line? So in this case, a vertical cutting plane would put a view over here, which is what I want in this case, and a horizontal would put it up above. So I'm gonna do, you can also do these angled ones, which is a little bit unusual. So we wanna have a vertical one. Now click on the center of the part if you wanna do a full section, which is pretty normal. You can do a section anywhere you want. You just have to be careful about what the results are gonna be showing you. So if you click on the center of that part, and then you have to click on this green check mark to say okay. And then you can either move your view to the left or to the right. In this case, I want to put this view over here and replace my right side view. So I'll put it over here. Now notice how it's identified, because I've been creating a bunch of section views here. This says D. You always want to start with A. So just highlight that and it should be a capital A. The first section view on your page should be section AA. The next one should be BB, etc. You shouldn't have a section C unless you have a B. You shouldn't have a B unless you have an A. So it's very easy to edit that. You can do it initially. You can come back in and change that. It's very confusing to have something say section D when you don't have an A, B, or C. And let's just say okay with that. So there's my section view. Now I do have a little bit of a problem here with space, because you'll see it does also put a title on that, which you can move that some, but don't get too crazy with moving it around. So we do have a lot. I've got a lot on this sheet, so just do the best you can. So again, now all those features that were hidden are shown as object lines. I can go ahead and add center lines, for example, just like I typically would. And add all my dimensions. It's a little excessively long. Add all my dimensions that I need to call out those features. Let's add another section. So let's say I still feel like I need a top view, for example. Notice what happens when I cut this view. The arrows are pointing this way, so I'm showing everything to the left of that. So it totally misses this part, which I need to see. So the easiest way to do that might be just to add a top section view. So go to View Layout, Section View, and this time I want a horizontal cutting line. Click on the center and I'll put the view up here in place. Oops, check mark. Put the view up here in place of my regular top view. And again, notice how it's going to try to label it an E. I don't want an E. I want a B, because this is my second section view. And again, I've got a little bit of real estate problem. I might want to scale these views down, quite honestly, if I can't fit. Once I start dimensioning, I'll find out the true situation. So now look what I get with the section B. I get a different look at the part, and I'll get to see this threaded part, which is pretty important because I need to call out those dimensions for those heights on those features. The thread is called out here, but I do need to call out some dimensions. Likewise, I would put my center line on there, and put all my dimensions that go along with it. So that's how you create a section view. It's pretty straightforward. Just pay attention to what you're trying to show with your section view, where they're located, and also how they're labeled.